We had been to Gore before.
I'm a lying believer that you're in love with me. The first gay man in New Zealand was born here in Gore in 1872.
And there's still a huge, thriving underground community of gay people who just don't tell anyone.
Gore.
Gore, the G's for gay.
That was all we said. Oh, and this.
Greedy old gay man's Gore.
Greedy old gay man sitting around the back of the fence, doesn't tell anybody, keeps it to himself, Gore.
Dirty old Gore.
Dirty old hidden pyramid scheme gay man behind the back fence, drunken old woman driving down the main street on a Wednesday night off to Halsey, Gore. Is that what it's all about, is it?
Be careful in the toilets at Gore. Gore's the boomtown capital of New Zealand.
It was those half-truths that angered Gore Mayor Mary Ogg. Elderly people in particular have been especially unimpressed that she said, the gay capital of New Zealand. She then wrote a letter to the West Coasters, and in the local paper it said, God help them if I ever see them again. You realise they're crazy, you wouldn't have them back in our town. If they come back, they'll be run out of town with blah, 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 blah. It was like she was mental.
We had to get to Lumsden fast, and the only way was through Gore.
Just to be safe. You know.
We don't have to do this.
Well, it's going to take work to go around the other way, otherwise, aren't we? It takes bloody ages.
Don't ever suspect me and this Princess Lowwick.
Confident that we'd blend in, we drove into Gore. As well as being the gay capital of New Zealand, Gore is the world capital of brown trout fishing, the capital of country music, and sister city of Tamworth.
Said, be careful on the toilets at Gore. Don't think they've forgotten. Don't think for 1 second they've forgotten.
Yes?
Hello, Gore.
When things are going well, Mike feels 10 foot tall and bulletproof.
Would you like to use the toilet?
No. Come on, Mike, there's some people coming. Come on, Mike.
Well, we went back, we buried the hatchet, we passed through Gore again, and there were no angry mobs, no elderly pensioners with barbed wire, and no Mary Ogg riding the back of a rhinoceros with an electric whip. And it's still the gayest town in New Zealand. Oh, homophobic Gore, where would we be without you?
In his hands, he's got the whole wide world. In his hands, he's got the whole world. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands. He's got this Mary Og. In his hands, he's got Mary Og. In his hands, he's got Mary Og. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands. He's got homophobic gore. In his hands, he's got homophobic gore. In his hands, he's got homophobic gore. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the state of New Zealand television. In his hands, he's got the state of New Zealand television. In his hands, he's got the state of New Zealand television. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands.